Hello, so this is the hardest boss of the DLC so far. Even the final boss, the Root Harbinger, was not this hard. Just because this guy just simply runs after you and when he hits you, you get slower and slower. The problem is that you can't really avoid his hits most of the time. Just because he has a big AoE, he constantly runs after you and he also has a fog effect, so sometimes you just put down the fog and then you can't even shoot him in the fog because you don't see him. I'm going to go with the old bleeding build. I mean, it's not as efficient as it once was, or I don't know what's happening. Because now it says over 20 seconds, and I don't know. Is it better because it's over 20 seconds, or is it worse? Also, I'll be using the Celerity Stone because I want a quick heal, and of course, a little speed. Other than that, I'm just a lazy build, specifically made for this boss. Also, I had to swap off some of my items, meaning my ammo boxes are no longer in my consumables because you really need the spice root potion on your bar. So, let's begin. Now, I don't actually talk so much during the fight because this is so annoying and he's so fast. Yeah, you're no assassin boss. Want all the glory for yourself? Now you see why I'm so angry about this fight. You barely had any time to react to his... what he was doing. So basically everything is a one-shot kill. Now, I don't want to change my build too much, so let's just swap the ring over here or something else. Yeah. He's waiting for his dinner and I'm the dinner. Probably should go with something that increases my damage a little bit more. In terms of survivability, there is not much you can do to this fight. Well, this could work, but again, we're not going to do that. Let's just get something more of the old ways. Now, I think I'll just try it more... Nah. We'll just go to more... Actually, the gift of Viscal, because we're not really getting a lot of damage inside anyway. Now, there are some people who will probably find a better way to do this, but I just don't care. It's supposed to be a fun fight, it's supposed to be a boss fight, you're supposed to learn from it, but... the more I play, the worse I get at it.
Oh!
Here, just do it like that. I don't care about the rest. Hey, some people find better ways. Some people just use a lighter set. Some people just dodge all over the place. But I think this is a very bad character design. This is almost like Gorefist and you don't have enough time to react. Anyway, worst boss fight in the game. At least with Gorefist you had more space to walk around. And even with so much resistance and so many stuff on me, you still get thrown around like 10 times in a row. Frustrating boss fights and design. Maybe we miss something in the arena, but if you get tossed in one of the spikes or the pillars or... you know, just near the edge, and you also have a lot of stuff to walk around. Anyway, it's a bad design and I hate it. We get the Obrix bracelet and now let's get out of here. Yeah, the arenas are just too simple, you need something. Just need something else, you know, to work around, to play around. And now let's go on. This is probably the first boss fight I'll actually leave one of my defeats, just so you see how I died a couple of times. So it doesn't really matter what armor you have, your traits, your buffs, nothing really matters. You just have to hit those dashes and hope for the best. Okay, nothing really here, nothing really there. No meaningful secrets over here. So let's get out of this place. We could escape here. Sometimes I wish I could escape the game and just go into an area where I can test my gear out a little better. Horrible boss design. I don't know what they were thinking, and I think he's bugged a little bit because sometimes he just wouldn't reach it. He would just attack, and that's it. 5 or 6 combos, I don't know. Maybe I misread the fight, but still, you can't really avoid him. Now this is the mines, or actually the place that you used to get here. And let me show you what you have to go through just to get to this boss. I'm surprised we missed that one. So I even died once or twice over here because it's all... about being chased by those many, many rats. By the way, this set actually works with this weapon, I checked. You should get at least one critical per hit if you hit with all of them. And that's what you have to go through. I think I got ambushed a lot of times here just because I didn't have enough time to go to the next section before they spawned. Okay, that's enough anger, that's enough show and sight. And I also want to show you the entrance of the mines. Sometimes I don't show this, but yeah, I should definitely show it. Because some people don't use the world analyzer. So the entrance to this guy is like this. I guess it's pretty simple. I think you have a different squall for the other mines. And you have the little thingy over here on the left. Okay, let's just go. Okay, let's take the long walk, because this is kind of like the final boss, so what do I think of the DLC? I think this DLC is a little overrated in terms of character progression, because you don't really gain anything here that you need, per se. It's just another type of weapon, another type of build. But the traits you get here are not as useful as the ones on Corsus. The ones on Corsus really, really made a difference. But the traits here, you can really work with them, and the trinkets you get here, again, they are, some of them are overpowered, but most of them are just there to exist. Oh, now I get lagged. Why am I getting lagged right now? Huh. I'm just playing an adventure mode to cool off, because this fight was too much for me. And this is probably the rarest fight in the game if you play Adventure Mode. I only got it once per 10, 12, I don't know, resets. So yeah, a lot of people think this is worthless version number 2. Actually, I should use that thing more. Yeah, actually, if you have any opinion about this fight, please let me know, because I'm a bit, I don't know, upset at it. Because I just don't understand, it's a very simplistic fight, but at the same time, that guy can bug out so badly, he'll kill entire parties by just comboing them to death like that. And now let's see what skill we got for all that trouble. I mean, the fight itself is not so bad, but you just feel like he needs more. Not just stupid difficulty. I mean, he doesn't have ads, he doesn't have minion, he doesn't have rat friends or rat soldiers, anything like that, but I think this time I would have preferred that he had a few rat soldiers with him instead of just those constant attacks with those constant dashes, combos and freezing over. Okay, this is probably a weapon mod.
Yeah.
Nothing too special.
Yeah.
Frozen mist. Time. 10 seconds, which apply frostbite. Bite.
You're done here.
Maybe, maybe not. Okay, now let's play a little the frozen mist until we teleport to some place we'll actually get it. Well, again, probably this is one of the coolest skills in the game, but not useful, not particularly useful with many builds. This is mostly for you playing and having fun. Yeah, let's go over here. So if you want to get all the skills and all the armors, I mean two armors and all the weapons, there'll probably be about 5 hours of resetting this on Adventure Mode. You don't have to play the campaign. I mean, you kind of have to play to get the last weapon, but that doesn't really count, because that's the final weapon of the game. Not of the race, so. Okay, now let's see what 3 stacks of this thing can do. Well, let's go into a village and say hello. Oh, so it's a grenade type. I thought it was more like a, I don't know, flamethrower effect or something like that. That was actually pretty efficient, because you just load the enemies and put down the turrets and shoot the enemies. So this slow effect could actually work, but again, if you just would have used another skill, like for example the wildfire or the kaboom, or the swarm, or anything like that that deals damage, or the fan of knives, it would have been probably the same thing, if not even better, because those do a lot more damage. Wildfire shot. This will be an amazing skill if you just use it properly. And the unstable quills are also pretty good. Also the hot shot. That burning effect can really add up. Also the blizzard is quite good at damaging the enemies and slowing them. So the mist is basically the blizzard, but it doesn't move. It doesn't deal as much damage. And you also have the big bomb, which I can't really find right now. The Song of Swords and so many other good skills. Anyway, see you next time. Bye.